Welcome back to more EarthBound. I've pretty much fixed up all my inventory. Got some more peanut cheese bars, you know, got rid of a lot of junk. So, the only thing I want to do right now is spend some time sleeping with Jeff. Well, no, having Jeff sleep. See if I can get him to fix a few things. That's not what I wanted. But hey, it sells, doesn't it? Ah, there we go, the broken iron, the slime generator. I think pretty much what it does is cause solidify, which in of itself isn't really that handy. I guess you can make enemies skip turns if it works. It's really good if you have Jeff really slow for some reason, and he goes last, and then enemies can't do anything, or use PSI on you. In some cases, having them use PSI is a bad, bad plan. But yeah, I'm going to cut out the majority of these, just because, well, I've already cut out like 3 minutes of this, so there is that. Yay. I don't think you can fix anything else, though. Thankfully, I don't believe, I've never noticed, Jeff not healing after, you know, working through the night, which would make perfect sense to me if he did that. You know, if he didn't get that full night's rest and healed, because it does say he worked throughout the night. Not to mention the possibility of keeping Ness and Paula awake. Anyway, I'm gonna sell these, if I can indeed sell them, and buy, well, more peanut cheese bars. Oh, boy. Yeah, it's pretty much a free $500, especially, you know, with this place. I don't have to worry about spending money. The amount of time I've spent sleeping, to confine it there for a moment, yeah, it would have cost me at a regular inn several thousand at this point. Yeah, the peanut cheese bar, I'm pretty sure, is the only unique thing. I don't even remember what the stag beetle does, come to think of it. But thankfully, I don't need to spend money sleeping here, so it's perfectly fine. I would suggest not trying to fix anything in a situation where you have to spend money on the inn. Not to mention, it's kind of a pain in the butt. At least here, all I'm doing is going in and out of this little hut. And that's it. Excuse me, Mr. Saturn. You're all Mr. How do you tell each other apart? Unless you're like beholders and you have slight skin variations and that's how you do it and most people can't tell, but that's a completely different game and a completely different subject that I will get into at some other point. Ah, Jeff leveled. Also, I've been a little obsessed with Paula getting her next thing of, you know, PSI magnet. I'm pretty sure that's a 24. If, you know, the list I looked at was correct and I'm remembering the right number, so it's not that far away. And trust me, PSI Magnet Omega is amazing. Especially with some of the enemies they fight just up ahead, actually. No, that didn't take long. They're pretty much free experience. Much rather do it here than out in Grapefruit Falls, because, yeah, armored frogs, the crocodile, which I haven't fought, the antoids a little bit, and not so much the zombies. Oh, I haven't fought you. Here we go. The plain crocodile, who's standing on his tail? I don't think they have that much defense. I don't remember. Let's look. And the farm zombies are no threat whatsoever. Yeah, the plain crocodiles hurt. Vulnerable to PSI freeze, that's not very good for you. Wonder how much that heals for. Does, anyway. Because, you know, there is the base range, and then there's, you know, vulnerable to it. Not a real big difference between swinging his tail hard and just a normal attack. Lots of experience, though. Huh. Not bad. Can always use more HP, but not so much on Ness, but other people, definitely. Especially Paula. I need to get some, vitality capsules for her. That'd be nice. And there is no reason not to use your PP at this point. Just to tell you. Just keep an eye on it, but don't be too reserved with it. There's a very good reason for that. Ah, two more levels. Just two more levels. And it's not going to be that hard. Where we're going, getting two levels is not difficult at all. Although I do, you know, some of the locations that this guy takes a picture, it's like, why are you taking a picture here? Like, in front of Ness's home. Woo. I mean, if he was coming out, embarking on his epic journey, that's one thing. But you're going back in. I don't know. Just one of those little nitpicks. But yes, you have to talk to that Mr. Saturn. And say the password. Now I have to wait 3 minutes. I'm going to cut this out. Usually when I'm doing this, I go to the bathroom, go do something else, make a sandwich, eat something. You know, because, well, it takes 3 minutes. Or, you know, in this case, I could just fast forward it, but meh. I wonder how many hours, like, in total around the world, have been wasted sitting at the Great Fruit Falls, such as this. It's kind of just, there's no way you could find out. There's no way you could figure it out. Because people who played this game so many times, they have no idea how many times they've done it. I'm sure it's enough time to cure cancer. there's always the little doubt, too, that while you're doing this, that, you've, especially once you're like a minute or two in, it's like, did I push a button? Did I do something to make, oh, there we go. Did I do something to make it not happen? And that was actually really good timing. The Belch Base. No. Then why are you here? And this is exactly the same, he's a little different, I guess. The slimy little pile. He's not quite the mini barf. Actually, wait. Let's take a look at him. Vulnerable paralysis, really? And apparently, Spy gets rid of stiffness, but that's strange. I forgot you guys called for help, though. And Ness could not stop Carapolis. Actually, that's completely pointless now. Paula, could you freeze him? Boy, it's not like the boys are going to be able to hit, even with Jeff's very good accuracy. Again, very accurate with it. But it's, yeah. Thankfully, now I can get rid of crying. Oi, and I didn't spend all my money. What was it, healing A or healing... Oh no, it went away, that's right. Welcome to... I don't know if these are fobbies or foppies. There's two different ones. These are essentially experience pinatas, foppies. They don't really do anything. They have almost no defense, low HP. They do have PP, so if you want to steal that from them, go right ahead. And 400 experience-ish a piece. Not bad. They're almost always in a line, so fire's a really good idea. It's one of the few times it is. I think they might even be weak towards it, which would be funny. Yeah, defense is 9, vulnerable to PSI fire. Yeah, you get a nice line of them, hit them with a fire beta, they all die. And 437 experience is mine. It's quite lovely. However, lots and lots of zombies. Now this, if I had higher levels of thunder for Paula, like beta or gamma or whatever, maybe Omega. Does she get Omega? I don't think she does. This would be a really good time to use it, but unfortunately, no. Unfortunately, I don't have these things. So fire is pretty much the best option. I think they're weak versus fire too. So fire does have its uses, as much as I say fire is not that great. Oh, you guys give colds. I didn't remember that. Yeah, let's not have that. So fire does have its uses. And strangely, Ness went before Paula? That's strange. Just because a character's speed is a certain number doesn't mean that's hard fact of who's going in what order in a combat. It just tends to be. Oh, bomb inside, that's not bad. Oh, wait. Colds persist, RPG, you don't want Jeff dying on you for no good reason whatsoever. But more foppies, please! This is actually a really good chance to get a lot of experience for not very much work. Especially when you get them in absolutely giant groups. I think this is pretty much as big as it gets. But, yeah, in this case, fire is amazing. That one's dead. That one's dead. That one's dead. So one little fire beta kills all four. I might not even need beta. It might be possible that I can get away with alpha. And yeah, this is the opportunity to get Paul up to level 24. And get the amazing skill of amazingness. So hopefully that will happen in the future. Not to mention, killing foppies in this area is not very detrimental to you. Especially once you find a certain room. There's a room in this area. It happens a few times in the game. Yeah, you'll see once I get to it. Ah, Ness leveled. Offense. That's fine. Not too bad. But this place is... Ooh, IQ capsule. Now, do I give it to Jeff, knowing that he requires IQ to fix things, or do I give it to Ness for more healing? Paula's not going to need it. PSI Magnet. I'm gonna go with Ness. Yes, IQ went off by one, so at least at some point, well, Broken Laser, I need to give that to Jeff. Because, again, if it's not in his inventory, it's not going to do anything. This is a very good chance to get experience. Especially... Oh, magic butterfly? I'll take that. Sure! And immediately spend some of that killing foppies. I think foppies also have, you know, some PP. I think I already mentioned this, but, if they try to do anything, they usually fail because they're unable to concentrate, and they can do it after a few turns. The attack slugs earlier in the game did that as well. Small level for Jeff, he got some HP. Woo. No problem here. Can I talk to the dude behind? Hello? What? So honest, mild boy? Okay. Apparently, Mr. Saturns don't entirely hate slavery. That's fine. Let's skip those guys for now. I think I can fight both of them. Let's skip going up there and murder the slimy little pile. Now, see this door? This door is really nice. Why? Yeah, there's a magic butterfly in here. No enemies spawn in this room, and the magic butterfly is here the majority of the time. I'm talking, you know, in the 90%. Maybe not that high, but it is very, very common to see a butterfly in this room. And let's face it, the amount of effort it takes to go in and out of this room is not very much. Not to mention, the butterfly can't run away from you. There are a few of these in the game. They're called magic butterfly rooms, for obvious reasons. Yeah, anytime you find one of these, abuse the hell out of it. You usually... You know, in this dungeon, maybe not so appropriate, but in later on ones, oh my goodness, these things can show up at the best time possible. I don't even know. Am I full? Almost on Paula. Yeah, so fully healed. Magic butterflies. You know, they're just enough of a boost, but not being game-breaking, unless you know where they spawn and where is a good chance that they will. That I cannot believe. So, the little piles aspire to be gross? Oh, and they don't do very much damage. Paula, how long until you hit level 24? Not very far at all. That's only a few comments and combats. And Jeff is caught right up. I think Jeff, if memory serves, requires the least amount of experience to get to max level. For some reason, I think that. But that's getting to max level, there's almost no reason, I think. Even if you get a little bit grindy, Ness might get up to the 70s. And that's pretty excessive. You don't need it. I think the flies are different either, too. I think they're mostly bad flies, yeah. Not really threatened by you guys too much. Yeah, there's PSI fire, freeze, paralysis. You'd be amazed how many things are weak versus fire that show up in lines. It's a little bit silly. But freeze is still usually the better option. Can you guys stop that? At least they're not as bad as the no good flies. I mean, those things were just there to try to get you into a red swirl combat. That's the only reason they're there. They don't do anything. All his levels now up to 24. Speed went up by 4. Vitality 1. IQ. Yikes. And PSI Magnet Omega. Ho 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 ho, yes. Not so much useful in slimy little pile fight, but, come a fight with many, many floppies? Oh, yes. It takes the guess at work out of, you know, going to new areas, too, where you don't know what has PP. And you just hit everything on the screen and answers so many questions very quickly. Actually, let's show PSI Magnet. Why not? Does not have PP. But, you know, that answer in one comment answered the question, oh, neither of these guys have PP. It's handy. I like it. That's not really that bad. But anyway. Next level. That's Hypnosis Omega. Think it, Hypnosis, which I don't even think I've used. Come to think of it. Same, pretty much the same concept as... yeah, I used the wrong PS. That was bound to happen. It really was. Oh, what was I going on about? Vital Capsule? I think that raises... HP. Oh, HP Sucker, that's good for Jeff. Calorie Stick, nice little pick-me-up. Pretty sure this increases, increases your vitality, so that is definitely something I want to give to Paul. I mean, she needs that. And the HP Sucker is for Jeff. I think, it does what you think it does. He uses it, steals HP away from monsters. There's another version that hits the entire screen, which is not as useful as you would think, actually. It's not that great. Well, when you first get it, yeah, it's fantastic. But later on, not so much. Little love for Jeff. Little level for Jeff. And now... Wow, that's a lot of floppies. Hey, guys! Oh, floppies. So apparently, a green swirl with two floppies equals instant win, but a black swirl with a single floppy does not. Don't get it. And Paula finally has 100 HP. Oy. Let's see, 79, that's not bad, 95, yeah, that works. And, well, why would you not abuse this room? just taking out using this room already seems like a challenge run, because, I don't know, for me, it's just so easily abused. Anytime you see, like, a little thing like this, and I think every single time I've tried this room, there's been a butterfly. Once in a great while, there won't be. But let's be perfectly honest, once in a great while, there will not be a butterfly. But those are just as rare as Picky defeating Starman Jr. So, there's that. You know, you guys, you have the space, but you have all these holes in the wall. Password. Don't say anything for 3 minutes? Extremely shy or extremely dangerous, or both? What a suspicious little fellow. Yeah, there was another group over here. I just did murder them off screen. There's no point in doing anything. Oh. Oh. Now, this is probably one of the most disgusting noises. I don't know, in 16-bit? Probably. It just sounds just bleh. And that's a really gross burp. I mean, you can almost smell it, and it smells horrible. Worse than the greatest evil. With true nausea. Now! If you don't have the fly, honey, congratulations, you are boned. You can't win this fight, literally. Right now, Master Belch has an infinite amount of HP, and it recovers every turn. So, have fun with that. But what I'm gonna do is defend, and we already know that he likes fly honey. I'm gonna have Jess and Neff... Yeah, somewhat nauseous. Don't know how he grabs it, considering he doesn't have hands, but that's perfectly fine. Now, Master Belch will do nothing in this combat except for eat fly honey. It didn't work? Did it not work? No, apparently I just didn't use it. But there is literally no way you can lose this fight. You go from a complete no-win situation to a guaranteed win. Because he will never attack you again. Open hypnosis. What? Is there another way to beat him? I'm pretty sure you need the fly honey, though. Because even if you hypnosis, he still would heal completely every turn. But then again, you know, I don't know... You know, the absolute mechanics of this game. I don't know everything about this game. And then there is literally... There's no need to do anything. Actually, let's use the HP sucker. Why not? Oh, or he could get defeated, whichever. It's like free experience. You have all the floppies in this area, and Master Belch is like, oh, here, fly honey. I win. Oh yeah, I gave you extra HP, and PSI Thunder Beta, that's handy. Maximum HP plus 10. It's like it was an even fight. Not really. Well, I suppose if you go from an unwinnable scenario to a can't lose, I guess that is balanced in some strange way. But Master Gygas has managed to get the Manny statue to foresight. So Master Gygas and the Manny statue are connected. Thank you for that little information. Let's deal. Suffer, Spanky. Oh, yes. Hello! Right. I think there's also a Mr. Saturn that, makes a little comment about us. I think it's this guy. Hello! Yeah, we stink. I mean, we just fought a huge pile of sentient vomit. One would stink after that! Let's not talk to him. See the ladder in the bottom right? Or kind of the bottom right? It didn't reach up here. Yeah, so at least now they'll talk to me. Hello? Now, in the interest of time, I would say no, but this being what it is... it's very relaxing. As far as the music goes. But, these sequences are very, very long. This probably takes like 3 to 5 minutes, I think. It feels like longer. I don't know if it's actually that 3 to 5 minutes, but it feels like a very, very substantial amount of time. Just because it's like... especially for, you know, if you read really quickly... you're sitting there waiting. Well, even if you read at a normal pace, unless you read extremely slow, it's like, oh, come on, scroll faster. This is why I have the text set to fast. Though if you've experienced the pain of battle many times, Not to mention the huge gaps. Steadfast, kind, and even pretty. It's always by your side. No comment. As you certainly know by now, you're not a regular old man. I can do psionic attacks. I have a pressure wave attack. Not to mention, I can heal the wounds of my friends with psionic abilities. Yeah, I'm completely normal. Everyone can do this. Oh, when good battles evil, which side do you believe wins? A faith that good is triumphant. Not always. Not always. Oh, there's also that guy that mentioned, he would give me something. I think he'll give it to me now. Now that I've, defeated Master Belch. This would have been a perfect part. Well, especially during the Belch fight to, you know, just chug a bunch of soda and burp throughout the entire thing. Just to be completely different than I normally am and edit everything out like that. Hell, half the time you sit there and edit out sniffs unless you're being lazy and playing a game while making sure you didn't, like, cough or anything. Next you must pass through a vast desert and proceed to the big city of Foresight. We're not actually doing that yet, so ignore that. He doesn't know what he's talking about. I wish you luck. Thank you. And you have to wait for it to scroll up. Don't like that. It's a long cup of coffee. We're 13 years old. We shouldn't be drinking coffee. The caffeine for a young man does not seem like a good idea. Hello. All home, you'd notice the population has gone up quite drastically. A lot more of them wandering around. Where is that guy? He was in this cave, wasn't he? Said he was going to give us stuff. I think that's this guy. Hello. You know room by later? Oh, yeah, the... has a third thing to give us. He literally gives you a bunch of stuff. Is it other? Wow. I don't remember how good the Mr. Saturn coin is really good. It's not even money, even though it's called a coin. It is really good. Although, what is a red rip? No. And get rid of the jar of fly honey, by the way. Yeah, it doesn't really do anything. That's handy. Why not? Give you a ton of defense. I need to get rid of stuff, though. I'm gonna call the Escargo Express guy. Get rid of the jar of funny. Fly honey? Because after you defeat Master Belt, there is no purpose to the item anymore. Oh, something I should mention. Something that's vaguely important. There is a limited amount of space you can stash stuff. You're essentially putting all this stuff in Tracy's locker at her job, even though she's like 12 and child labor laws. I have no something. I don't remember what the stag beetle does. So Tracy does have a finite amount of space that she can stick things into. Gone after one use. Yeah, because it crawls away. I'm gonna free the little guy. He doesn't need me to hold on to him and have him in my pocket. He will become very upset. It's better if he's free. I mean, it's not like it's a stink bug or something malicious. It's just a stag beetle, just going around, having a good time, and somehow the mistress... Where do you guys keep things? You don't have pants. You obviously don't have pockets. You don't have a shirt, because you don't have a torso. Where do you guys... It must be in the nose. It must be. Where else would he do that? Where else would he stick things? Bar the other really gross answers. But anyway, next time... I started the part right here, didn't I? Next time... I need to go to the upper right of this... quirky little village. Because as much as I want to go to Dusty Dunes Desert and Foreside, there is... one more thing we need to do before we leave. Until then.